Hi, Wendy. How are you?
Hi, Charlotte. I'm fine. And you?
I'm all right, thanks. But it's good news has come. We can go outside now more often and things are going to open up. Yes. Hairdressers and dentists and everything. And today we're going to start again with the Witch's Oracle Tarot from Marla Brooks. And we are getting nice reactions from this. People are really interested on my side. And I've seen your viewers are also very interested. And today we're going to start with the Merkaba. Yeah. And that is like the, it's like the Jewish cross, actually, the cross of St. David. That's what it always reminds me of. It's different than the pentagram, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Merkaba. The Merkaba is an extremely powerful symbol. It is combination of two star tetrahedrons. One is pointing up to the heavens, channeling energy down from the universe to the earth plane, and one point downwards, drawing energy up from the earth beneath. The top or upward pointing tetrahedron is male and rotates clockwise, while the bottom or downward pointing one is female and rotates and counterclockwise. It is a divine light vehicle allegedly used by ascendant masters to connect with and reach those in tune with the higher realms. Its crystalline energy field is composed of specific sacred geometries that align the mind, body, and heart together. This enables us to experience expanded awareness, connects us with elevated potential of consciousness, and it restores access to and memory of the infinite possibilities of our being. The message of the Merkaba is simple. Your motivations are the foundations for what you want to manifest in life. And if those motivations are based in fear and limitation, that will be all you will get. Excuse me. But if you are motivated by your heart and your true inner power, there are no limits, and abundance will be yours. The crystal that represents this card is selenite. It's a bit orangey color. Selenite is the crystalline form of the mineral gypsum, and it is a powerful channel for divine light. Selenite floats the body, mind, and spirit with the light from the higher realms, casting out fear and darkness, and allowing you to operate from the perspective of your higher self. The incantation or the affirmation that one can say is, knock down the walls that have kept the fear in, throw out limitations, and let me begin to trust in the power that lives deep in my heart. Now is the time for a brand new start.
Een beautiful card.
Thank you.
Ja. Deze kaart die staat dus van ja, eigenlijk voor in contact komen met je hogere zelf. Lichaam, met je lichaam gaat samenwerken met je mind, hè, je gedachten en je hart.
This Wendy says this sign stands for your higher inner self and bringing yourself and all the elements together.
Het is ook van, hè, ga voor je doelen in het leven, zonder grenzen. Ga ervoor en je kan het echt bereiken.
Go for what you want. You can really do it. Be motivated. Be activated or come into action. You can really, really do it. Believe in yourself.
En dus één zijn met alles en alles om je heen. Alles, ja, dat mag uitkomen. Je mag het ook weer terug ontvangen.
What you give, you shall receive. You are allowed to receive, and you'll get it back threefold. Just be one with everything around you, especially nature.
Ja, daar staat deze kaart voor. Yeah.
And that's what this card means. So now we're going on to Merlin. Okay, the next card is Merlin. And he's like the Merlin the magician. And obviously, he is a magician and witches, or he might be a wizard. He was really known as a wizard.
Yeah.
Okay, Merlin. The legendary Merlin, the wizard, the sorcerer, and the magician is one of the most fascinating figures in Welsh literature and Arthurian legend. Merlin was a man of mystery, magic, contradiction, and controversy. Surrounded his life, he appeared as an old wise man, giving his wisdom to four suggestive British kings. He was known as the Wild Man of the Woods, during which time he learned to talk to the animals. Merlin was reputed to be the mystical druid, the Celtic priest, a man who possessed knowledge and secrets of the ancients. And he was especially revered as a great prophet, but he also possessed human qualities that led to his eventual downfall. The meaning of the card, the fact that we are, after all, only human, is the message that can be derived from Merlin. Being the best we can be, following our hearts and forgiving our stumbles along the way is the key to peace of mind and tranquility. The crystal is gem, flint is flint. Flint occurs worldwide and innumerable flint artifacts and offerings have been unearthed in sacred sites, especially those in the British Isles. Flint is the stone of the magician. It takes you to the threshold between the worlds of for magic and transformation. A humble but powerful stone, flint reminds you to own your humanity and find gifts that make you unique. The incantation or the affirmation, I call on Merlin's wisdom now. Being kind to myself, I must allow. I am not perfect and will never be, but I accept the missteps, and that is the key.
Ja, beautiful. Magisch eigenlijk de kaart, hè? Zeg ik altijd.
She says really beautiful and magic. Magic.
Ja, die uitstraling van de kaart, ik vind dat een mooie kaart. Want, yeah.
Ah, Wendy's coming alive here. She's smiling. She understands it better. She says it's magical.
Deze kaart, hè, van Merlin, is het leef vanuit je intuïtie en vanuit je hart.
This card of Merlin is live from the heart and your intuition.
En die laten jou zien, de weg, die laten je als het ware de weg zien die goed voor je is.
This card actually shows you which path is the right path for you.
En alles zal gaan zoals het gaan moet.
Everything shall go the way it should go.
Ja, het gaat vanzelf eigenlijk. Okay. En daarom is het eigenlijk ook een beetje een magische kaart, zeg ik altijd. Van als je tot jezelf kan komen, je eigen ik, daarvanuit leeft, dan gaat het vanzelf. Omdat je werkt met de gedachtekracht van Merlin.
If you work with your thought and power of thought, and you work with a pure heart, and you do it with love and purity, then everything will magically happen just by itself.
Daar staat de kaart voor, mooi.
Oh, she loves that card. Okay, next card, we're going to the mirror.
Yeah.
And then, the mirror, I always have to think of Snow White, the queen, the evil queen.
Yeah.
She was a witch. Mirrors date back to ancient times. The first mirrors that people used were mostly likely pools or dark, still water. It is believed that the first glass mirrors were invented in 1 AD by the Romans. In the medieval period, glass mirrors completely disappeared because during those times, religious confessions stated that the devil was looking and watching the world from the opposite side of a glass mirror. In folklore, mirrors were objects to fear. They were said to steal the soul, and that they were the invention of the devil because they had the power to draw souls out of the body. Some believe that spirits can become trapped in mirrors. Although there is much negativity and superstition associated with mirrors, one thing is for certain: mirrors don't lie. When we gaze into the mirror, what we see is the true reflection of ourselves, both the good and the bad. We cannot deny the image reflecting back at us. Take a good look at yourself, but look deeper than just the surface image that is reflected. Look deep into your soul. Do you like what you see, or are there changes that must be made? What are you doing, Millie? Sorry. The crystal or gemstone is obsidian. Obsidian has long been polished into scrying mirrors, as its dark surface makes it a master of reflection. Obsidian is a powerful stone for revealing your inner landscape. It is an honest guide that reflects what is in your hearts and your minds. Work with obsidian when you need to reveal what lies beneath or below the surface, so you can heal and transform it. The incantation is: mirror, mirror on the wall, I welcome you to show me all. I need to see all sides of me, so a better person I will be.
Oh, beautiful.
Thank you.
Deze kaart duidt aan dat spiegels die liegen niet, en ze laten jou de ware jezelf zien.
This card is just showing your true self. They don't tell any lies.
Het is een reflex van jezelf, of het nou goede of slechte dingen zijn. Dus het kwaad of het, ja, good of the money. Yeah.
It is a reflection of you, whether it's bad or good, that it's showing, okay?
De kaart die duidt in principe aan dat je diep in jezelf moet gaan kijken van: hey, wat moet ik veranderen? Wat kan ik beter nastreven? Wat is goed voor mij en wat niet?
This card also suggests: have a good look at yourself. And not just surface-wise, but within yourself. What can I change? Good or bad?
En zodat je ook sterker in je leven mag staan. En wat je doet, op wat je keuzes ook zijn, zorg dat die zorgdraagkracht voor jezelf wordt.
Dus dat so that you can really stand in your strength.
Ja. Ja.
Okay. Yeah. I've got itchy nose. Archangel Michael is here.
Oh.
I love Archangel Michael. Right, we've got the mortar and pestle. Can you see it?
Yeah, I can see it.
Mortar and pestle. Alchemists, herbalists, witches, and scientists have used the mortar and pestle for thousands of years to grind herbs to a fine paste of potion, spells working, and in making incense. Symbolically, the mortar and pestle represents sexual completion, the unity of male and female influences, a balance. The mortar, like most cup or bowl shaped objects, is seen as the female, a vessel. The pestle is phallic symbol. It is by itself a tool of destruction, but in combination with the mortar, it is an instrument of creation. It is time to get busy, create your own recipe for things to come, but very careful in the concoction you choose to use, because some of the ingredients could be poisonous. The gem is moss agate. The mucreal energy of agate stimulates mental creativity, while the moss-like inclusion is this gemstone symbolizes growth and fertility. Connect to most agates to deepen your connection to the plant kingdom for inspiration in making your own magical blends. Incantation with mortar and pestle, mix it up, ideas and plants toss in a cup. Crush and grind them one by one until I feel they are perfectly done.
Ja, mooi. Ja, deze kaart staat eigenlijk voor het mannelijk en vrouwelijk. Eigenlijk bijeen. Voegen samen in een geheel van het beland.
Okay. This is this card, Wendy says, represents bringing things together to become one.
Het mannelijk en vrouwelijk, dus voor beide samen. Het is in principe deze kaart duidt aan, het is aan jou om de juiste ingrediënten te verzamelen. He, voor je eigen goede bestaan in het leven.
What Wendy is saying is, you have to decide which ingredients you are going to use to cast a spell to improve your life.
Ja, en ga dingen aan dat het passend is in je leven. En let wel op welke keuze je maakt. Wees doordacht daarmee.
Oh, die is moeilijk. Kan je het stukje bij stukje doen alsjeblieft?
Zeker. Ga het leven aan.
Prepare life. Accept life. And handle life that fits for you.
Ja, klopt. En let wel op welke keuzes je gaat maken. En doordacht daarmee. Doordacht welke keuzes je gaat maken en wat je gaat doen.
So be careful what you choose and what you decide, and use them wisely, so that and watch out what you do and how you do it, so that you can improve your life or style.
Ja, dat die uitwerking dat het kan verlopen zoals jij graag wenst, zodat het één belang.
So that the results will be what you wish it to be. Okay.
Ja, dat is het kaart. Mooi.
Thank you. Sorry, sometimes it's difficult to translate. Nee. You know why.
Yeah.
Then we have the owl.
No, beautiful.
I love it. The way he looks at it. Look at it. His eyes.
Yeah, mooi.
He's sweet. Owl. During medieval times in the Western and Central Europe, it was fabled that owls were actually witches and wizards in disguise. To this day, the owl is considered a witch's familiar pet, in other words, sharing unique spiritual communication between each other and even sharing the same secret powers of the night. The owl has been deeply connected with magic, shamanism, and heightened scenes throughout the ages. Some have thought of the owl as a cat with wings, as they share familiar characteristics of personality. Owls symbolize wisdom, the ability to see things that are hidden, omens, deception, observation, and total truth. Trust your intuition at this time. Pay attention to what is going on in your world, and you will not only instinctively know what to do to solve those issues that have been weighing heavily upon your mind, you will be able to see and bring about things that are yet to come. The gemstone is lolite. Lolite is considered a stone of shaman's path. It helps you connect your spirit guides and help you scratch the surface to see more than simply what a situation appears to be. Lolite teaches you to embrace the unknown and it encourages you to think outside the box. Great Owl, this is the incantation. Great Owl, I trust in thee to unmask the things I cannot see. Give me the insight to fix what needs mending and brings about a happy ending.
Yeah, beautiful cards. I love the owl. Yeah.
Beautiful. I love the owl.
Yeah.
The owl became very popular because of Harry Potter.
Yeah. Harry Potter. Deze uil is de wijze uil. Ja, vertrouw op je intuïtie. Op je eigen intuïtie vanuit jezelf. Ja, wat gaat er in de wereld? En wat gaat er in om je heen?
This owl is the wise owl. He can have another perspective, or he also means a wise old owl, but he looks down at things and what is going around in your world and in the world.
Ja, en ook jij kan kijken. Kijken om je heen, observeer. Ja, neem waar. Alle zintuigen die je hebt, neem waar. Zoals een uil kan doen, kan jij ook.
Look around you, look all over, you can see things, get a different perspective. You can even see things that others cannot see. Believe that, but be conscious of looking right. Don't stare in front of you, but stare, look around you.
Yeah. Nou, en gebruik ook al die zintuigen en laat het een boodschap zijn die je binnenkrijgt. Een gereedschap waar je mee mag gaan werken.
Use all your senses, your visuality, your auditivity, your verbality, your wisdom, your third eye, your heart, your solar plex, your touch. Use all your spiritual talents and senses. So that you can use it to your advantage. Believe that.
Nee, gevoel en intuïtie laten spreken, maar ook daarna gaan leven. Dat is gewoon heel belangrijk.
Listen to your intuition and your emotions, but also live accordingly to those senses.
Ja.
Whew, that's nu hebben we 5 kaarten gedaan. Really great. I love those cards. I like your insight and your opinion. Love it. Two minds think the same. It's great fun. I love doing this with you. And this is the 9th episode.
Yeah.
Doesn't time fly by?
Yeah. It's beautiful.
Are you getting really prepared and excited to move home?
Yes, yeah.
And the boys?
The boys also too, yes.
Okay. Well, I hope you stay safe and be well. And I'll see you next week. Take care. God bless and be blessed.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.